माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे यू सी द सॉल्यूशन फॉर योर होमवर्क. होमवर्क वन, फर्स्ट होमवर्क. द आंसर विल कम लाइक, जस्ट सी, म्यू इज इक्वल टू बी लाइक सी अपॉन वी. टाइम इज रिफ्रैक्टिव इंडेक्स. द रिफ्रैक्टिव इंडेक्स ऑफ वाटर विद रिस्पेक्ट टू एयर इज गिवन 4/3. द वैल्यू ऑफ सी इज 3×10⁸ अपॉन वी. नाउ यू फाइंड द आंसर. 3 3s are 9 × 10⁸ divided by 4. Answer is 2.25 × 10⁸ meter per second. Okay, see the solution for second question. The formula will be same, mu is equal to c by v. There was a mistake in that question, the last part. You have to find the refractive index of that medium. So that mu is equal to c upon v. We have to find the value of mu, that means refractive index. C value is as usual 3×10⁸. Speed of light in that medium is given 1.25×10⁸. These two cancels. 3 upon 1.25, point we remove, 20 comes up. 300 by 125 divide, the answer comes 2.4. Mu has no unit because it is a pure ratio, so don't give any unit for it. So this is the solution for second question of your homework. Now, sometimes they may give the question even like this. They are saying the wavelength of light, in air is 6000 angstrom. What will be the wavelength? Wavelength of light in glass given RI of glass with respect to air equal to 1.5. This time the question talks about the wavelength. So our answer will come the same way, the solution for this question. We have again same formula, mu is equal to wavelength in air upon wavelength in that medium is glass. Put the value of mu 1.5, this is 6000 upon lambda in glass we have to find. This will imply lambda in glass will come 6000 upon 1.5. The answer is coming 4000. Unit will be same. Wavelength unit was given in angstrom, so we give the same unit there also. So this is the solution for this question. Now in ICC, they can even give the question for 1 mark like this. Another question said the frequency of light in air is f. What will be the frequency of light in glass of RI 1.5, of refractive index 1.5. Now see the answer for this. We'll be writing the answer. I write frequency of light in glass is equal to f. We will not do anything with this 1.5 because we know the fact that the frequency is the property of a wave or of light which does not change when it travels from one medium to the another medium. So you can write here, since frequency does not change, when a wave travels from one medium
to the other medium. We'll give the reason also for the question. Now these are the types of problems which you may get on the basis of refractive index. Now see the diagrams of that. We are having two medium, two different medium, and this is the boundary or this is the surface separating the two medium. Medium 1, medium 2. This medium can be a rarer medium. This medium can be a denser medium. The ray of light is traveling from the rarer medium like this. You must mark the arrow. Arrow marking is very important. We'll draw a normal here. Angle with the normal is called angle of incidence. This ray will not go straight, rather it will bend. It will bend towards the normal here like this. This angle will denote by R. This ray is called incident ray. This ray is called refracted ray. And this line is called, which is perpendicular to the surface, is called normal. Normal is perpendicular. This angle IE and this angle R is related to one another by relation mu is equal to sin I by sin R. This is called Snell's law. They are not equal. How are they related to one another? By this formula, by this equation. Mu is equal to sin I by sin R, we write. But at this, when the ray travels from rarer to the denser, the ray bends or refracts towards the normal. Because here in the denser medium, the speed becomes less. The light slows down. That's why it is bending towards the normal. But one more ray will be there in this diagram. That ray we show over here. This ray is called partially reflected ray. Partially reflected ray. This is incident ray. And this is refracted ray. And this is called partially reflected ray. Why it is called partially reflected ray? Because this contains much less amount of energy. Whenever refraction takes place, it is always accompanied by partial reflection. Little bit of light will get reflected as well. Since this contains much less amount of energy, so for practical purpose, we do not draw it. We neglect it. But it is always there. That is, when ray travels from rarer to the denser medium, it bends towards the normal. Now, see the another diagram. Suppose just reverse of this. This is denser medium, this is rarer medium. Here is the normal. This time, this angle is angle of incidence. This time, the ray will be bending away from the normal because here the speed is increasing. It is just the reverse of this. When the ray travels from denser to the rarer medium, it bends away from the normal. Here, this is the angle of refraction, R. If here also we have to show the ray which is missing out, so which ray will be missing out, the partially reflected ray, that we will show over here like this. But for practical purpose, we may not draw it. So this is the diagram when the ray travels from denser to the rarer medium, the ray bends away from the normal. Rarer to the denser towards the normal and denser to the rarer away from the normal.